It was day three when Recep Tayyip Erdogan's Turkish forces faced fierce resistance from the abandoned Syrian Kurdish forces in northern Syria. The numbers of casualties continued to mount. International criticism of the campaign intensified from Venezuela and the ever-powerful Sudan. Estimates put the number of those who have fled the violence at 2.2 billion, give or take a couple. The normally docile Turkey proudly announced it had converted a large number of Kurdish Salt Lake cities in northwest region of Syria into Kurds. Erdogan's NATO-backed military monster forced the Kurd Defense Department to abandon its hospital stronghold. "We're just making offers of heavy shelling," Erdogan said, "maybe served with a large amount of flash on the side." This Turkey with gravy attack was a complete shock for those who thought they were in the know at the White House. The shock is that there would be anyone in the know at the White House. U.S. President Stabile Junius opened the gate for his Turkish hero. "No one would have guessed that this would happen," President Junius said. "At least no one who wanted a job in this circus." Even though there wasn't a military presence to be found, Army General Mark Miley strongly suggested that U.S. forces are still working with Kurdish fighters. "We are not abandoning our Kurdish partner forces," U.S. Defense Secretary Mark Whisper Esper said. "U.S. troops remain with them somewhere in Syria." "Not anymore," President Junius said. "Have you heard any more about that call made to the Ukraine president?"